Not supposed to. Firstly, can I just remind everyone, please remember to like, share, comment, and subscribe. That'd be very helpful. I've lost a few subscribers. I don't have that many, so a few more would be handy. I know I do need to find a new game really to put a bit more content on. I keep sort of trying different games and starting them and then being like, this gets a bit meh. Anyway, there we are. This game's still sort of holding my attention for now, although there is a discussion about overpowered heroes, of which there definitely are some, including not least the new season 2 1. I can't summon because that event is over. Now there is a mass weapons event out. I haven't really done very much, to be fair. I do need to sit down. I need to do collect gold as well, so I've got a few tasks to do. It's just been a busy couple of days, basically. That's the way it goes sometimes. Anyway, we're jumping into the tournament now. Attacks yesterday, obviously I somehow won them all. Defenses of, oh, hey, there we go. So that's pretty good. 3 out of 4 wins. So I'll take that. That's looking good. Now, yesterday was a bit of a bloodbath. In many ways, it was a challenging, very challenging tournament. Some really tough opponents to face off against. Going to bring in my Pumpernickel again and Trackdown and Lottie. So those are three of my better reds. This guy has. I wouldn't have gone with a green tank. As I say, the obvious one to go for is yellow because you can't colour stack against them. Then again, not looking like a promising board, so you might get away with it. Some red tiles in damaging places would be nice. Not going to happen today. Come on, some reds, reds, reds. Oh, reds, but not in the right place. I suppose it wasn't too bad. This should finish off Nash. There we are. So you can see why they've gone with this green, the two blues either side of him. That is quite an effective tactic, that. I still think that it probably doesn't undo the effects of taking a green tank. Personally, I think you've still made life harder for yourself by doing that. That said, obviously, I have just lost a hero, which is a sure sign that that not things aren't going terribly well. But I do think the odds are sort of heading in my favour, even allowing for a few special attacks and what have you. CMYK, yeah, does quite a lot of accuracy down, which is quite annoying. Combined with Pumpernickel can be very effective. There we are, dead. Hooray! Okay, going into the next one. Oh, yeah, predictably enough, Pumpernickels. And blues. Blues and pumpernickels. That sounds like a military regiment. No, it's blues and royals, but blues and pumpernickels sounds good too. So I'm going to do what I did last time and basically just go colour stack blue and just hope for good boards. Want to break through the wall of blunderbusses. At least the first one should die on the first move, and hopefully this might kill or seriously injure one of the other ones. Yeah, it did pretty much. So I'm going to target over towards this side. I can't remember who hits more than one person. That's one of the blunderbusses down. Ingrid and Jem. There we are. The blunderbusses are all out of it. That's a pretty good start, really. Can't complain at that. This is obviously the beauty of colour stacking and the danger of taking a tank of a colour I can colour stack against. I get that Pumpernickel is quite effective, but it's a risky strategy when I can take a load of blues. So there we are, Captain Doom. Bye, bye, bye. Right, let's head on. Okay. This guy's gone with the right idea of lots of yellows, but it's confusingly gone with a green tank. Don't quite understand the logic there. Would have been better off putting one of the yellows as a tank. Yeah, it just seemed an odd choice that. I know this guy, I can't remember his name, Kaichi, is quite effective as a tank because he does like he heals himself and all those sorts of things. He still doesn't really sort of, it's not going to forgive the amount of colour stacking that I can do against him, which means that it sort of creates a hole straight away in their team where I can ghost tiles and such. And as you can see, that sort of then opens them up to sort of begin opening up the other side of their team as well. A risky strategy and one I would suggest you don't roll with. It can be, anyway, it's a risk, isn't it? I personally would suggest you're better off going for the tank of the colour I can't colour stack against, because the tank is going to get most of the tiles in the first few moves of the raids. Realistically, it's not that often that you're hitting any hero other than the tank in the first, you know, let's say four moves on average. But that's, I mean, it's a guess, obviously. I haven't counted it specifically. But until the tank is dead, they take most of the tile damage. And if you can colour stack against them, they die more quickly. That simple. Okay. Now, this team has gone for the right colour of tank. This one's a bit of a tricky one. It probably is going to make sense, I think, to go with blue. I will keep my pumpernickel to counteract their pumpernickel. This is one of those ones I could also have gone with red, but then they've got two blue heroes which would be weak against. So I'm just going to roll with this and see what happens and just hope things come together. It's, to me, this is what I would suggest is a well put together team, for the most part. Could question having quite so many reds and blues or whatever, but it's, yeah, you're kind of beginning to stretch it a little bit if you say that that's going to be a significant issue. Their Tannenbaum, of course, is going to go off. That's going to make my life harder. Well, mind you, if I get my pumpernickel to go off, that'll blind them a little bit. Right, let's go for the accuracy down thing here. Could do with my Tannenbaum going off, really. I think with a bit of luck, I might kill their Tannenbaum on this move. Not Tannenbaum, sorry, pumpernickel. I keep getting too many names that, I know they don't sound particularly similar, but I do struggle with Tannenbaum and pumpernickel. Just long names, I guess. Mind you, I struggle with many things in life. Tiles, there we are. We've got some blue tiles in play there that are going to do a reasonable amount of damage. Unfortunately, their Tannenbaum is going to go off, along with Sea Captain Ned. So the Sea Captain the double there, that's bad news. This should get some blue tiles into action. My Tannenbaum can go off. The issue here is really just breaking down that defensive wall that they have established with their Tannenbaum. Oh, I thought that would kill that guy. I really did. I thought that was going to finish him off. Yes, so that's annoying. I thought he would die then, and he didn't, which is making it rather tricky. I was hoping my pumpernickel might be ready, but he's not. This is getting annoying now. I can't quite break down this team. Only sort of plus side is it doesn't appear that they are breaking down me either particularly effectively. Tiles. Defense down against red. Oh, can I? They're not linked together for a turn. May as well blow this and see what happens. This is going to be one of those very long-winded raids, I think. I'm still not quite sure where it's going. They have certain advantages, and so do I, so it's a tricky one, this. I am going to have to... I mean, ideally, what I want is to get rid of their Tannenbaum or the Sea Captain. Created some reasonable holes. They're not linked together at the moment, so let's try and do as much damage to Tannenbaum as I can. Not going to be enough to actually finish him off, of course. And now they're all linked together. As, of course, am I. So now I'm linked together too. Their armour rating is going up, I would have said, quicker than mine. Which is concerning. This is going to come down... This one, I think, I'm pretty sure at this point... is going to come down to a tiebreaker. I'm not sure how many moves we've already played. I think the accuracy down thing might count in my favour, possibly, because their accuracy is going to be lower down than mine. My accuracy is minus 12%. I think it's only, as far as I know, it's only Tannenbaum does this accuracy down thing. Lacking I might try for a second. I'm going to just leave it, let a couple of the special skills get ready and try and do a big attack with special skills, which can work. I don't think it's necessarily going to here because I've got too much health. If I can get, I know. Right, what are they? They link together. Share received damage. Yeah, that's fine. Thought it was. Right, so let's put some armor back on. Two turns of shared received damage. Oh, I think I just have to go for it, really. My accuracy is doesn't seem to be improving. I thought it was supposed to improve when Thingamabob died. Is there somebody else keeping me inaccurate, I wonder? My Tannenbaum. There, Tannenbaum. Here's the tiebreaker, as I predicted. This one's shaping up to be a doozy, isn't it? 5 minutes left. I think that the tile damage is going to start going up and up and up and up through the roof fairly quickly. If I can get a few sort of decent moves. Oh no, that's good. I thought I killed my Pumpernickel then, but no, he survived that. There, Tannenbaum going off. Tile damage. It doesn't seem to be doing that much, my tile damage, I gotta say. Considering what percentage damage we're at, we're at 170% already. I would have thought it would be doing more than this. Okay, then there, Squid Fella is going to go off. Does a lot of damage to this old Squid Fella. If these hit, that would be good. A reasonable amount of hits there. Oh, Squid Fella's dead. That's the first of their heroes to go. But one of mine's died as well. Oh, this is going to be a close one. I think that will get. Oh, that took out two. Oh, there we are. 200% damage, and it was just enough to tip them over. What a raid! What a raid that was. That was a close one. Fourth raid. I have to remember that. Oh. Collective sigh, because here we go again. It's the same basic thing. Same basic thing. Me versus them. Same basic problems. So it's going to be the same sort of issue, probably. If I can kill somebody quickly, I have a chance. If I can't, then it will almost certainly drag on for a while, unless they kill me very quickly, which is also possible, of course. Just thought of thinking about trying to target their red heroes with blue tiles because that will do a bit of extra damage to everyone. Not easy though to get blue tiles into them. That did a reasonable amount of damage to Tannenbaum then. It's not going to be enough to kill him by any means. Some tile damage there. My guy, CMYK, is going to blind me though, which is really going to mess me around. Sharing is caring again. Sea Captain's healing them all again. And their Pumpernickel just wiped out half my team. There we are. This is over then. This is over. If I'd survived one more turn, I think I was in a position I could have actually got some good moves in. But hey ho, not today. No coming back on this one, I don't think. Not now. It's so annoying having these red blue tiles over here just sort of sitting staring at that Pumpernickel at the end, who could have been taken out with a couple of hits. Just hasn't happened. Right choice of tank, a well put together team this. It was never going to be an easy one by any stretch. I don't think I'm even going to scrape a point here. The Tannenbaum effect. You kind of need Tannenbaum to die very, very quickly. And that time he didn't. So yeah, that's a sad end to what had been quite an effective run, really. Leave me top 5%. I knew I wouldn't be. Obviously I'm going to stay top 5% because I didn't score any points. 512th on the leaderboard. Let's just have a quick look. Yeah, yellow. I think Tannenbaum you're going to see as a tank an awful lot. Tannenbaum, 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 Tannenbaum. CMYK, yeah, that's it. It's good to see an awfully lot less of the teams with just pumpernickels, because I don't think that should come up too much. It's still a little frustrating to see so many pumpernickels near the top end there. Yeah, so there we go. So, well, there we are. C'est la vie. End of the tournament, end of the day for me, but it's not too bad. I can't complain too much. So I'll be reasonably pleased. So hopefully there was something useful in there in terms of advice and help for everybody. And it just remains for me to say, au revoir, goodbye, and may death come swiftly to your enemies.